turn your radio up louder, louder, just a little bit louder, because the next hour, you're going to be tuned in to Donnie Jones Live with Donnie Jones and Mardy Ringer.
Hey, can we just stick with Mardy? Because like that Mardy ring, it don't have that ring to it, you know? I'm just saying.
And Mardy, with your hosts Donnie Jones and Mardy, sponsored by Don's Tree Service. It's Donnie Jones Live, right here, right now. Right now. Donnie Jones Live.
Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to Donnie Jones Live. I am Donnie the Tree Lady hanging out with...
The Mardy Ringer.
The Mardy Ringer.
Yeah, you know how they do like Ohio State. The Mardy Ringer. I want to be something special. I don't know.
But you are something special, man.
Yeah, but not... Yeah, I want to be special in a good way. You know, that's okay. Special.
Not know? Special as a special
right.
Education,
yeah, yeah,
right?
Like touched by angel. You special, no.
You are touched by angel, man.
Anyway, it's a good day. So how are you doing?
Man. I'm doing good. I can't complain. Happy about this new year. Happy about making things happen and getting life going for 2019, man.
Yeah,
you know, I'm still on that high.
I still got a 2018 funk. You know, I still got it, the clothes, the smell. I haven't gotten to the 2018
Mardy,
yet.
Mardy,
yeah. Slowly
you know,
but surely though.
You got to let 2018 go and embrace 2019. New ideas, new visions.
New women, new people.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. Just a new direction in my life.
I want to hear your wife hear you say something about
why
new women.
Why you always bring that up, huh?
Because I'm,
No. See, that ain't cool. You know, every time I start talking about my goals and dreams, what about your wife? You know, you just a hater. Just
that's
a born again
I'm
hater.
In your business.
Right,
that's why.
Okay, we got somebody else in here. Let's talk about him.
We're going to talk about him, too. But how was your weekend, man?
It was, you brought up my wife. That was a bad experience. My weekend was good. I wasn't around my wife. No.
Oh my God.
I love my wife. If she's listening, you know, I love you. And that God is with you right now. You know, I don't love him a whole lot, but
well,
we all good.
Maybe that's why I should stop bringing that
yes,
up. See, I
yes.
be trying to bring it full center. Now, who the heck did not turn
is
the phone on?
Is that your husband calling
that's,
you?
It might be my husband.
Yeah.
I love my husband.
Even does he love you? No, I don't
oh, he does,
you.
Baby.
Anyway, let's talk about this guest that you have brought
in
here.
I am going to talk about the guest, but I thought you might want me to talk a little bit about the Trees of Life, but we ain't got to do that.
Okay, but tell me something about the
but
Trees
since
of
you
Life.
Was I ain't going to tell you about no Trees of Life.
Nah, we're tell me about
no, because you mad that I'm bringing up marriage. Speaking of marriage, segue, I got to know this gentleman. I got to know this gentleman. He's a great man. And when I met him, I was so impressed with his demeanor, his attitude, and the beautiful lady that he was with. There was such a beautiful vibe of love and commitment between the two. And so I ran into him a few months later. I was like, man, you know, you and your wife seem like y'all just got the game and gone with it. It's a beautiful spirit. And I loved your energy. And I said, you know, I got to get to know you better. But once I got to know you better... this gentleman by the name of Eric Payne, I found out that he's a man on a mission. He's a man making a difference. And I said, I need to know more about your story and why you're the way you are. So talk to me a little bit, Eric.
Wow.
Yeah.
that was a lot.
True.
Well, I guess. Where would you like me to start? I mean, we met a couple times.
Yeah, we met a couple times, but the first time I met you, you were with your ex-wife.
Right.
And we,
which
me and
you
your
refer to
ex-wife
as my wife.
Yes,
see,
I refer to you.
Stuff out there
I'm just saying.
I see that.
But this is the reason why we're here, because there's a lot.
Because, the ex-wife.
No, we are.
See, that's just hate. You going to highlight this?
No, we are here because what I noticed
divorced.
was.
That's wrong.
You are so silly. We are here because once I got a chance to know you and found out that was your ex-wife, but that you had this beautiful spirit about you and that you were helping other people kind of get this peace about themselves, I asked you, how did you do it?
Oh, right,
and what
right,
were you
right,
up to? And you told me some of the things you were up to. And so that's why.
Okay. I mean, so when we first met, you guys were cutting up at a recital. We should
okay.
Let's include
okay.
this.
Okay, now we're gonna put my dirt out there.
Yeah.
So we were at a school recital, our children's recital, and I was sitting there listening to the children. You know, at recitals, the children are doing the best they can.
They were doing a great job. Mm-hmm.
For kids.
For kids.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
For kids. Right. Yeah. Put in that disclaimer.
Right.
For kids.
Right.
Yeah.
So my ex and the lovely Donnie here.
Yeah.
We're cutting up.
Yes,
quite
we
a
were.
Bit.
A little bit. A little
it was,
bit.
It was a lot.
Yes.
It was a lot.
Okay.
Yeah. But anyway, we met again, what, at the birthday?
At the pumpkin party. Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, essentially, got divorced 3 years ago.
Congrats.
Look, you're in a bad situation and you leave from there.
And you know what? And you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right.
The theme.
That's why they was at peace with each other.
They ain't got to go home. Exactly. Right. But what I noticed about you was that you took your pain and you turned it into power. And right. It seems like that.
Yeah, it was just the name of my podcast.
From Pain to Power. Oh. That's the name of your podcast.
The Pain to Power podcast.
Yes. I love it.
It goes along. A little play on my last name.
Pain to Power.
P-A-I-N, not P-A-Y-N-E.
Well, Eric Payne, tell us about that.
All right, so basically, 3 years ago, got divorced, but it wasn't just divorce. So my father had a stroke, and in November of 2014, my ex-wife started hinting at divorce in January of 2015, I'm sorry. Son got asked to not come back to school in May of 2015. The divorce happened in June of 2015.
Gotcha. So 2015 wasn't a good year.
And then there's more. I wanted to stay in the marriage, but you know, ultimately if it's not working, it's not working.
Right.
I had to have some good buddies come by and move me out because I was not like because I refused to leave, but because I just was paralyzed.
Right.
So got started on my new life and got all flying fabulous and angry. In September and went out and bought an expensive car. I used to work at an agency. I was an ad guy. And then 3 days after my birthday, by the end of that month of September, they laid me off.
Bought this fancy car.
Gotcha.
Right.
So over the course of 10 months, I mean, it was scorched earth. I mean, I had a life in November of 2014. Yeah. And by October of 2015, everything was unrecognizable.
Everything changed.
Yeah. Yeah, it was like, and so here's the thing. My father's name is Job. And I'm like, I'm not Job.
Wow.
So why is this happening to me?
Right. It just jumped the generation.
Right. Your mama named you Job. Right. You named me Eric.
Right.
Eric is some old, you know, Nordic ruler
type
thing.
Well, he was trying to get you to jump over that curse, but it didn't happen. Huh?
Right. Yeah, no,
okay.
Sins of the father, clearly.
Yes. My father has some sins too, so you know we're gonna leave that alone.
I got some sins.
Let's just say there's some kids in St. Louis that look a lot like us.
Oh, I have an Uncle Calvin that has a lot of cousins named Calvin.
Gotcha.
You know, I'm gonna be honest. All of my uncles have an extra child. In between. I'm serious.
It's
like nine of them. Yeah. You know, nine uncles, and each one of them got one little child in between their mixture. And it's not a good thing at a family reunion sometimes.
Right.
You know, but things happen.
You move on, and you can't be upset
with, you know, somebody's birth or anything.
Right. Absolutely.
So anyway, definitely. But now how did you start changing that?
How did I pull myself out?
Because that's the reason why you're here. There's a lot of divorced people.
Of course.
But I'm trying to get divorced.
Right. But I think the divorce kind of sat in the middle of all the rest
of
it. It just was amplified by everything else. I mean, I had two kids. I have a young girl and I have a older son. He's 23.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the whole point was I had to show up for them. I didn't have a choice. So, you know, I wasn't going. So I was a mess for a while. I was very messy.
Right.
Very much in my feelings, very crying and woe is me. And if, you know, if I had met y'all, I would have told y'all my whole story and then some.
Right.
After hello.
I can believe that. You know, we're going to get more into that story. How you got a podcast. How do they reach or tune into your podcast?
Right.
So it's on SoundCloud. So it's soundcloud.com/paintopower, P-A-I-N-E. Oh, sorry, P-A-I-N-T-O, power.
Okay.
Yeah. Repeat that one more time.
Yeah. Sure. soundcloud.com/paintopower.
Perfect. And then how do they get in touch with you directly if they want to? Or do you want them to just go through SoundCloud?
Right now I'm in a digital rebuild. You can find me on Instagram at Eric, ERICLPAYNE.
Okay, well, great. Well, Donnie, I need my check next week. So we got to go pay a bill real quick. So in a minute, we're going to have to go. And, you know, how do they get in contact with you, Doni?
Well, you know, the way they get in contact with me, and I'm going to go real slow because people say I say it too fast. It's DoniJonesLive@gmail.com. That's D-O-N-I, Jones, J-O-N-E-S, D-T-S at Yahoo. That's a lot from the pen of hell.
You sound real special right now.
I know. That is the wrong L-E-I. That is not it. No, because my other email. But anyways, it's Doni Jones Live. DoniJonesLive@gmail.com. That's DoniJonesLive@gmail.com.
We'll be right back.
Exactly.
Hey, this is your girl, Doni the Tree Lady, owner of Don's Tree Service. Don's Tree Service has been serving the metro Atlanta area for almost 20 years. I'm a certified arborist, and we are fully licensed and insured. Call us at 770-413-TREE. We give free estimates, and we don't charge extra for cleanup. Don's Tree Service, that's 770-413-TREE, or visit us online at donstree.com.
So the reason we went with Don's Tree Service is we needed a couple things done at our house. We needed some trimming of some trees done, but then we also had this old, big, beautiful tree in our backyard that was, our deck was built around this tree, and it was just getting old, and limbs were starting to fall, and we just knew eventually it was either going to land on the house or we needed to have it taken down. So we called around and got a few quotes, and then we met with Don's Tree Service, and they were just, they were awesome, and we ended up going with them, and I can't say enough about their work. They came in with their crane and got the tree down, and it looks great. It looks great. I would definitely use them again.
Hey, got a comment about the show? Or would you like to just be a guest? Send us an email at DoniJonesLive@gmail.com. Now, back to more Doni Jones Live with Doni and Mardy.
Welcome back to Doni Jones Live. I am Doni the Tree Lady hanging out with
Mardy the guy. I need a hook thing. You know, like Mardy.
I thought you had one.
No, I can't use yellow butter every week.
No, you know? It was the other one. It wasn't your stripper name. It was the other name.
The M? I don't know. We're going to figure that one.
That's all right.
I got a suggestion for my name. Just contact Doni and let me know.
Exactly.
Because I need some help with that.
And something other than his stripper name would work.
Yeah.
But guys,
before we I don't know. Go ahead.
Before we went to break, we were talking to Eric Payne, and he was talking about how he took his pain and turned it into his power. And I wanted him to kind of expound on that a little bit more.
Sure. So, I mean, ultimately, I was wallowing around on the ground, and
Yeah, if that's not Jesus, put it on hold.
Exactly.
Okay,
Jesus, you know, on the main line.
Most people put their phones on silent or
vibrate.
You know, when we're on the radio.
And my phone was supposed to be on silent.
Yes.
Go ahead.
But yes, Mr. Payne.
Yeah.
Please continue.
Mr. Payne,
please continue. Just Donnie's having a moment over there.
A whole lot going on up in here.
Right, this is live radio, people.
Right. I'm sorry. So, you know, I got two kids, and I just felt like I had to figure out how to stand up for them and overcome the situation. You know, I started to read a lot of books on relationships. I started to, you know, I did something different, actually. Instead of doing I'm 47 this year, so I was turning 44 that year. I turned 44 that year. So instead of doing what most people do, which is, you know, find a young lady. I mean, I did get the car. The car is, I mean, it's white, but that's my little red Corvette, as I refer to it to people.
Right.
You know, because it took me a year to realize I bought that car when I was angry. I thought I was just buying it because I liked it.
Right.
So,
yeah, no.
It was your angry. It was your divorce car.
Right. It was my divorce mobile. Yeah, definitely. So, didn't go out and find a whole bunch of women or do any of that kind of stuff. I just worked on me, which was tough because it unearthed a lot of stuff that existed before that time. Now, I'm, you know, some of it led to the divorce, I'm sure, or some of it played a role in the breakdown of my marriage. But at the same time, it just turned into an opportunity for me to self-determine, figure out who I am, figure out what happened, what went wrong, and just get it all out so I could start living the life I wanted to live.
And what are some of the specific things you did? Because once again, what impressed me so much was the way you and your ex-wife carried on and were able to communicate and then also raised such an amazing young girl.
So you caught,
or basically what advice would you have?
You caught me at the end, right?
So right.
I wouldn't say it was.
Is that why she was happy and talking to me and you was just there like, mm-hmm. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, I mean, you pretty much
you were at the concert, yes.
Yeah. No, I mean, the first thing I had to deal with, right, is that, so here's the thing. A lot of times in marriages and relationships, you make the other partner more important than you. And when you do that, you're doomed. Right.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
there's no more you in that relationship. And usually you're doing it for the sake of the other person, and that other person doesn't even appreciate it.
Right.
Right.
So what I wound up having to do was give myself my importance back. I had to determine that, you know, required a lot of meditation, a lot of praying, a lot of affirmations, honestly. I mean, to be perfectly frank, I probably spent the first few months not able to look in the mirror. I mean, it was very problematic when it came to getting ready.
Okay. I can understand that.
But being able to not look in the mirror, was it because you just weren't happy with their reflection, or where you just feel like you weren't attractive anymore because of the divorce? What was going through your head?
I think it's a combination, right? You know, it was not mutual. I was the one that was left, the leavery.
Is that a thing?
I was the one left behind.
Yeah, basically. Right, right.
Uh-huh.
And it's so interesting that you say that, because that's what I thought, I was left behind. And then, you know, the positioning, a lot of times, one of the things I learned in the gabillion books I read is that there's a transference of guilt.
Okay.
So the guilt was transferred on to me as to why everything was wrong.
Right. Right?
Yeah.
So high and dry, left to the side, ain't worth nothing, ain't about nothing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I can actually, honestly, all joking aside, I can relate to that, because sometimes it was a point in my marriage, you know, where we got separated. We've been separated back and forth. We just like yo-yos in a sense. But it was a point where I was wondering, like, I don't understand this. You ain't got a job, woman. You ain't got nothing, and you still leaving me? How low can I be?
You know,
I'm serious though, because and it made me feel like, wait a minute, I must be worse than a man, you know?
Because, right.
But, you know, and y'all laughing, but these are the things that go through our mind, because you know, as a man, you want to feel like your spouse loves you and you empower, and you like the champion,
right?
And you matter. And it's like, ain't nothing I can do to make you happy,
right?
You know, I'm taking care of everything, and you still wanting to leave.
Yeah.
It does do something to your whole psyche.
Yeah.
You know, and
absolutely.
It is that, you know, I can go out there and try to find me somebody new, but no, you know, because it's not just going out there having sex with somebody, you know, because it's that emotional. And sometimes you have a plan for your life that you said, okay, I thought we was going to have this for forever.
Right.
And now all of a sudden you're not on the plan.
Right.
Well, can we fix it?
Right.
You know, and you just say, no, what
the heck? You know what? I will say this, coming from a woman's perspective. I'm in a marriage where I'm pretty happy. You know, my husband's pretty happy. At least I think he is. But from talking to friends of mine.
He's very quiet. He's very quiet. I ain't going to say happy. He's just quiet.
Well, I believe my husband. Is your daddy happy, y'all?
Don't y'all. No,
just, oh, don't bring the children into it. Don't bring the children into it.
But what I've heard time and time again is communication.
Mm-hmm.
They don't feel heard.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't feel their feelings are taken into consideration. And they don't feel emotionally supported. As a man, did you hear some of that? Or,
yeah, but I mean, but here's the thing, right? And I'm, you know, we'll see what the chorus, if there's a chorus to what I'm about to say.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of times, it, you know, one of the things she said to me in the aftermath was, you know, one of the things that is most destructive to a marriage. And I said, what? She said, well, unmet expectations. I said, well, how about uncommunicated expectations?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? The number one mistake that I think spouses make, particularly female spouses, is the belief.
Why are you looking at me?
Oh, I am. I mean, because you looked at me.
It would be weird if you looked at me. Okay, yes.
I ain't trying to start no fights up in here.
I'm like, I thought you released all of that. No, I'm just kidding.
Look. One of the things is the belief that your man understands because he loves you.
Mm,
your man don't know nothing until you tell him.
Right.
That's true.
Yeah.
Like, seriously. And if you're not talking, he's thinking everything's all right. Not that things are going off the rails.
But have you heard men say, because you do, you have basically started a movement where
the divorce whisperer. Yeah,
you are the divorce whisperer. Have you heard women say to men, about men, that they didn't feel heard, and then the men say, you never said anything?
Yeah. I think that both people are miscommunicating.
Okay.
Period.
And let me just say this, with a lot of relationships, it's love language, you mm-hmm. know, and
yeah,
we speak different
true.
Love languages,
yeah.
you know, is words of affection or, you know, reformation that some people love just to hear
right.
you love them.
Right.
And other people, like, you can tell me that all day, but that don't mean nothing. You need
right.
to do right. something
right.
for
right.
me.
You need,
you know,
like some people do it through gifts.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Some
gifts.
Through physical affection.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah.
And sometimes you just really speak in two different languages,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I've been in so many arguments with my spouse. And it's one of those things that we notice later on that we're arguing, but we're arguing on two different things.
Right.
You know,
yeah.
and they're talking, but it's two different things. And it's frustrating because she hates my guts,
mm-hmm.
you know, and I'm like, I don't know why. What? I didn't.
Right.
What is it that I'm
right.
doing or not doing? And sometimes,
do you know what her love language is?
Oh, no. She gave me the book. I just didn't read it. That was one of the things she was mad at me about. She did.
Oh,
I didn't read the book at all. And then after we split up, I started trying to look at the book.
Right.
But, you know, and really, it's just really, like you said earlier, I believe that communication and understanding what the expectations are.
Right.
You know.
Well, in our next section, I do want to talk about what you're doing with your podcast, From Power to Pain. But before we get into that, you had mentioned that men didn't know that the expectations weren't being met. What can a woman do so that she is getting through to her man?
We got to talk. You know what I'm saying? Oh. The biggest thing the biggest problem with talking between people that are actually intimate or friends with one another, that kind of thing, is that they don't want to hurt each other's feelings.
Mm.
Right.
And they also don't want to risk the pain of how that person might react to something that they're saying, a good,
right.
hard, honest
mm-hmm.
truth. So I'm not going to say anything because, you know, it's all right. I can deal because I'm not really trying to rock the boat. I'm not trying to cause no problems.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if he's going to go off, that mm-hmm. kind of stuff. And then you don't do that. And then you start building a well of resentment.
Well, as
yeah.
a woman, when do you, I would like to know, like I said, from my friends, not for myself, when is a good time to talk to the guy?
Well, like if y'all in the bedroom and you want him to spank it like it's crazy,
oh my
you know,
goodness,
don't make
dude,
love
you...
to me. No, don't be nice to me. We ain't treat me like your old, you know. That's
oh
what they
God.
Really. I'm saying you got to be honest like that.
Once
because
again,
that,
we aren't communicating.
Right,
because
we ain't
that
communicating.
Ain't what I was
you
want to
cuddle? I want. But anyway, Donnie, again, how do we get
in touch with you?
Your yeah. podcast, because I think your podcast is you know really touching some people, and you know because you coming from the heart, and
yeah.
men like me can relate.
So it's on sound. It's actually across all platforms, but it's called
okay.
It's Pain to Power, P-A-I-N-T-O Power. It's on SoundCloud, Stitcher, iTunes.
Okay.
And you can just type in Pain to Power.
And we'll be right back on the other side of this break.
Yeah.
Hey, this is your girl, Donnie the Tree Lady, owner of Don's Tree Service. Don's Tree Service has been serving the metro Atlanta area for almost 20 years. I'm a certified arborist, and we are fully licensed and insured. Call us at 770-413-TREE. We give free estimates, and we don't charge extra for cleanup. Don's Tree Service, that's 770-413-TREE, or visit us online at donstree.com.
So the reason we went with Don's Tree Service is we needed a couple things done at our house. We needed some trimming of some trees done, but then we also had this old big beautiful tree in our backyard that was our deck was built around this tree, and it was just getting old and limbs were starting to fall, and we just knew eventually it was either going to land on the house or we needed to have it taken down. So we called around and got a few quotes, and then we met with Don's Tree Service, and they were awesome, and we ended up going with them. And I can't say enough about their work. They came in with their crane and got the tree down, and it looks great. I would definitely use them again.
Hey, got a comment about the show? Or would you like to just be a guest? Send us an email at DonnieJonesLive@gmail.com. Now, back to more Donnie Jones Live with Donnie and Mardy.
Welcome back to Donnie Jones Live. I am Donnie the Tree Lady, hanging out with
Pastor Mardy Ringer.
Yes.
Yes, see, I'd use my real title for a change. Yes.
Praise That's a great
him.
Title, though.
Yes.
That
you
is
know,
a great title.
Because we're getting into the spiritual aspect of
That's
it, right?
That's right.
This
That's
is the spiritual
right.
aspect of the show. And, you know, you said something the other week that inspired me. And
what
actually,
was that?
Actually used it in church this week, this past week. She told me about this lady that she went to her house.
Yeah.
And because her tree limb that was giving
Falling
good shade
out.
Over her house
mm-hmm.
fell down. And she
mm-hmm.
said, baby, can you put my limb back up there?
Yeah.
Because it was really giving me good shade.
Yeah.
And she's like, no, I can't do that. I can't do that. But then, you know, Donnie said, you know, I think God does us the same way.
Yeah.
You know, and, well, we do God the same way. We take things out of our life and we still try to put it back together.
Right.
And it's like sometimes things need to be moved out, you know, for us to be better. You know, I spoke to a lady last week who, when I first met her, she was dealing with her relationship, her husband, and she was fighting for it really bad. She's like, Pastor, can you talk to both of us? I'm like, I don't know him, you know, whatever, you know, but they had some problems. They actually divorced. And I talked to her last week, and she sounded more happier.
It was the happiest thing she ever did.
She sounded more confident, more happier. And sometimes you don't know that, you know, God is trying to take you away from something.
Yes.
You know, it's kind of like you're in this garden that you're happy with.
Yes.
You know, you're in this garden full of a whole lot of manure.
You know, but manure makes things grow, though.
Yeah, but when he's trying to take you
out of it,
you know, you start thinking about what I like being in that manure.
Yeah, it's warm.
Sometimes, it's warm, and sometimes you get so used to the smell,
you can't even smell it.
Smell it.
Mm-hmm. I think you done just took everything that I was gonna ask.
I was trying to set up the platform.
Because I was gonna ask you about the spiritual aspect of getting to the other side.
So. After spending, I did spend a certain period of time trying to reconcile, right? And to your very point, nothing was working, and I was sitting somewhere, just frustrated, and I said, you know, nothing's working, nothing, and everything I do pretty much works a little bit, but this isn't working at all.
Yeah,
and I'm talking out loud at this point, and I said, you know, I feel like I'm fighting you, God. And I kind of like fell back into myself, and then I said, okay, like I'm not messing with
let
this.
It go.
I said, this is bigger than me. I said, I don't know why you want this. And this is before with foreknowledge, you know. I said, I don't know why you want this, and I'm scared, and I don't know what's next, but I'm gonna let go, and I'm gonna rock with you, because this is ridiculous. I can't do this anymore,
right?
And I got a house 2 weeks later.
Look at you.
And I you know what I had to do is that I had to stop looking back over my shoulder, memorializing a past that no longer existed, and then walk into the unknown and just do a true faith walk. And that's the fear, you know. And my biggest fear, to be perfectly honest with you, was not that I couldn't do it alone, was that I could do it alone. Because if I could do it alone, then that meant that everything that I had been working for, fighting for, holding on to had been smoke.
But it gives you so much strength, you
know, and, it does.
And God, I think, pushes you to your true destiny,
right?
And sometimes we are so just we want to be happy, but sometimes we're not ultimately happy. We're just satisfied, or we're just in this place, you know.
I think that for me personally, and I think that a lot of people, if it's all about perspective, right?
Right.
Yeah.
So for me, certain things didn't happen in my childhood. You know, for lack of a better way to put it, I grew up with no common sense. You know what I mean?
Right.
I was raised under a strict household and never went outside and just got chewed up by the outside. You know what I'm saying? So what ultimately
are you saying you were sheltered from a lot of the craziness?
Yeah, sheltered from a lot. I grew up on the south side of Chicago. My parents are both one of nine. I'm an only child.
Okay.
They you know, there was no street lights for me because I was never outside.
So they were trying to protect you from the hurt and pain of
whatever they came from, all life, what they came from,
right.
You know, what was happening in Chicago.
Yeah.
However, and both of my parents are academics, so they spoke to me tremendously about being smart. So I was smart, but I didn't have a shred of sense in my head.
Mm.
They didn't talk to me about living life.
Wow.
Book smart, but not street smart.
Right.
I mean, my dad was pretty much on the you know, I say this gently, on the Bill Cosby tip. You know, education is the door. You know, as long as you're smart.
Okay. Thank you for clearing that up.
Yeah, I said gently.
He did a few things gently.
He was gentle.
No, but education is the answer to all things. And it's not. You know, you have to know how to navigate. You have to be savvy.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And I think that my experiences, for whatever they were, snapped me out of the generational cycle that I think a lot of everyone in my family, well, no, I don't want to say everyone, but then a lot of people that I've witnessed in my family are in.
Well,
like, I'm broken. I'm out of the matrix now.
Right. Mm-hmm. But now that you're out of the Matrix, can you look back and be thankful
for some of the sheltering? Because I don't, Well, I mean, my parents, you know, here's the thing about parents. I forgave my parents, and I think that a lot of people in my age group are in the same space. My parents did the best that they could with what they had.
See, this is crazy for me. Mm-hmm. I'm going to be honest with you, Eric. This is crazy for me because you had, like you said, for lack of a better word, let's just call it that Huxtable lifestyle, right? And, you know, so to speak. Whereas I grew up being exposed to a lot of the craziness, having to be able to, you know, have to work outside. My dad, you know, some great years, we had great years, some were bad year. We lived in the hood for a minute, then we moved out to the county into better areas, but I was still exposed to all kinds of crazy stuff and our family and stuff. And so it's,
I thought she learned the first time.
I thought I turned it off. But that's crazy. So, with that, I thought, you know what? I'm not messing with you.
So with that,
your children are looking at you.
I'm gonna hurt them too. I'm hurting everybody up here. With that said, can you see how it's kind of hard? I forgot what the hell I was going to say. Go ahead, Marty.
Yeah, well, you were just talking about your upbringing and trying to understand, connecting it to his upbringing. Right. How it's different. That's what you were talking about. Yours was so different.
Like, I would think that that would be the utopia of growing up, that it would have you prepared for a great relationship because you didn't have to deal with a lot of dysfunction from the streets.
But I think what has to happen is that your parents have to see who you are and then raise you according to that.
Okay.
That's true. You know, everybody's upbringing, you can always say, okay, this one was better, this one was worse. And it's like, really, everybody's upbringing is unique.
Right.
You know, I wasn't in the south side of Chicago. I was in a place called Watley, Georgia, a little bumble, little sticks kind of place under ministers the whole time. And I hated it, you know, but it made me who I was now.
Right. And you're in ministry now, but you do it in your own.
I hope God ain't listening right now. I love you, but sometimes you're dealing with people. But you know, it's now you got me messed up. But you know, your upbringing, makes you who you are.
Right.
You know, and you got to take what your parents. They weren't reading the books. The parents for idiots.
Right.
You know,
right.
They wasn't reading that. And a lot of times, I still got to forgive my mom. Because I'm like, you were just stupid growing up.
Oh,
I mean,
my
raising
goodness.
Me. But she didn't know any better.
Right.
You know, but one of the things my pastor says is that you have to be, you know, and this is something that you have to determine as an adult. And, and hopefully, you know, God has his hand on you to kind of like snap you out of it. But you have to look at how you were raised or understand that they're basing certain experiences on you that are completely unapplicable.
That's right.
For the time
that
you're growing up in.
That's right.
You know, both of my parents, my dad's from Pontotoc County, Mississippi. You know, he was always outside, always working with his hands, so I can DIY anything.
Yeah.
But the stuff that they were applying to me didn't apply to who I was.
Right.
You know, and I have that conflict with my daughter. Well, I don't anymore, where I wanted certain things for her, but then my daughter, like, her spirit raged forth. So I was like, all right, let me fall back.
You gotta let them be their own people.
I'm gonna work with this protoplasm,
absolutely,
know, versus imposing what I want on.
Absolutely. Well, I tell you what, we're gonna take a break. But once again, how can the people get in contact with you? And we're talking with Eric Payne, from Payne to Power podcast.
Yeah, you can find me on Instagram at Eric L Payne. The L is for Lenny. Actually, no, it's not Lenny, but Eric L.
Eric. Oh, now you want to be funny.
I thought it was being funny all along. Eric, ERICLPAYNE on Instagram. And my podcast is Pain to Power Podcast. And you can find that on iTunes, Stitcher, SoundCloud, and Google Play.
Awesome.
It's too many social media places now. Periscope, Snapchat, Twitter.
But I don't think people are doing Periscope that much
anymore. No.
But, you know, only old people do Facebook now.
Yep.
Yeah,
I guess I'm old in because I do Facebook and Instagram.
You said you guess you old in.
Yeah, I'm
cool. I accept it.
I'm old in.
But guys, we're gonna take a break. We'll be right back.
Hey, this is your girl, Donnie the Tree Lady, owner of Don's Tree Service. Don's Tree Service has been serving the metro Atlanta area for almost 20 years. I'm a certified arborist, and we are fully licensed and insured. Call us at 770-413-TREE. We give free estimates, and we don't charge extra for cleanup. Don's Tree Service, that's 770-413-TREE, or visit us online at donstree.com.
So the reason we went with Don's Tree Service is we needed a couple things done at our house. We needed some trimming cutting of some trees done. But then we also had this old, big, beautiful tree in our backyard that was, our deck was built around this tree. And it was just getting old and limbs were starting to fall. And we just knew eventually it was either going to land on the house or we needed to have it taken down. So we called around and got a few quotes. And then we met with Don's Tree Service and they were just, they were awesome. And we ended up going with them. And I can't say enough about their work. They came in with their crane and got the tree down and it looks great. It looks great. I would definitely use them again.
Hey, got a comment about the show? Or would you like to just be a guest? Send us an email at DonnieJonesLive@gmail.com. Now, back to more Donnie Jones Live with Donnie and Mardy.
Welcome back to Donnie Jones Live. I am Donnie the Tree Lady hanging out with...
Mardy, not the tree man.
You like the tree man. But you like trees, right?
I do like trees, yes. I like the real good trees with a whole lot of THC in them.
Oh, my goodness. I'm done with him right now.
Look, I tell the truth and keep it straight.
That's true. Tell the truth and shame the devil.
I sure do.
Well,
before
we went to break, we were talking to Eric Payne and what he's been doing to just become what we consider the divorce whisperer, as you will. But you've got a lot of rituals that you, not a lot, but I've seen you do some rituals on Instagram and fitness and health.
So here's the thing.
Talk about that.
So again, moving forward. It's all about moving forward.
That's what I mean.
And it's actually physically moving forward. I mean, you do it mentally, you do it, but you do it mentally, you do it spiritually. And then I think it needs to manifest physically.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
So one of the things that I have gotten into, I mean, since I was younger, I've always been into fitness, but I've really gotten into it now. I have a morning routine. I mean, you know, just like anybody in the Army or whatever, I make my bed, I get up, I jump rope for 10 minutes a day, work out for a little bit. I have a garage with weights and stuff set up in it. I joined, this is on my journey to me, right? I took a spin class with a bunch of youngins, what I refer to as youngins is mid-20s to 30-year-olds,
yeah,
or whatever, and
yeah,
I'm riding just as hard and fast as they are, and they don't know if I'm possessed or if I'm drinking some sort of...
drinking some sort of
bad juju, you know, they're like, you know, you were the coolest dad ever, or can you be my 40 goals? They don't know what my deal is, but I think as far as that reinvention piece, that is my drive, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you can find all the things that I'm doing because I want to roll it out into a larger service package. You can find that on my Instagram page because I have links in my bio.
Oh, that's great. So what are some of the larger things that you're going to be rolling out now that we're in 2019?
Well,
getting
a dirty look from across the
table. Because we talked about this. I'm pretty excited
about
it.
This last Thursday.
Yeah, she likes putting people on the spot.
Right, you acting like you've been counseling me.
Right.
We sat over.
I can't counsel. What was that name of that place? Taquero Luna, whatever it is.
Taqueria Tsunami.
So
can I say something about Tsunami?
Yes, talk to me.
I said this morning. Why do people feel comfortable naming food establishments after one of the worst natural disasters ever?
I know.
You don't hear any place being called volcano?
No.
Tornado?
No.
Rainstorm?
No.
Slavery?
No.
You know?
I mean,
have you ever?
Right.
No, we got discount on slavery.
Slavery burgers.
Well, the name of your company is going to be Masters Fitness, so right. I mean, that reminds me of slavery, but I understand what you were.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, I was using that, but see, I moved away from that because since we talked, the Masters piece was because, you know, when you run races, that's the category of the 40-plus crowd.
That's true.
But, upon doing some research, there were some very scary things that were coming up under Masters. A lot of elderly, over-muscled people.
Gotcha.
Bodybuilders.
Okay, I thought you were going back to slavery.
Thinking something different, like Masters, you know, like tie them up and, you know.
BDSM.
Yeah, one of those type of things, yeah.
Absolutely. So you're segueing away from that piece, but you're still doing your fitness, you're just going to call it something different.
I'm going to call it something else. It's in process, but I mean, like I said, you can if you visit me on Instagram, in my bio, I have a link tree. Which links to a bunch of different links. I have a YouTube channel with my workouts on it. My IGTV has workouts on it. And, you know, just follow me.
Well, you know, one of the workouts that I saw you doing was the jumping rope.
Mm-hmm.
That was so cool because it's such a simple workout,
cool,
but it's powerful.
Jumping rope.
Do you know how people always talk about how many calories you burn and how you get, it's like total body workout?
I know you can burn a lot of calories. Yeah. I'm saying it's real healthy, but she was like, can you explain how you do that? How do you jump over that rope so over and over and over again?
A noodle. I'm going to beat you with a wet noodle.
Just jump and leap and leap and just jump.
How do you do that jumping? I mean, you'd be twirling that rope.
Well, actually, you did. You had the little skip. You had the little boxer skip.
I had
thank
the,
you.
The pleasure.
Y'all make fun of me.
I was fortunate enough to box a few years ago. And I had a boxer teach me how to.
So you're just all around Renaissance man, huh?
Yeah.
Marketing, boxing,
jumping rope. I can write. I'm a writer at heart, actually.
Yeah.
So I had a blog back in the day. It's still live. You can visit it. Oh, here's a shout out for you. MakesMeWannaHolla.com. It was one of MakesMeWannaHolla.com.
Okay.
It was one of the top dad blogs, black or white. Dad blogs. It was just mainstream dad blog, and I talked about before my daughter came, I had I have a son, and my son.
This is why I wanted to go ahead.
My son was real source material.
Yeah.
Because my son was the type of dude who he played football. I said, hey, don't come home with the sneakers that you run in. Just leave them in your locker. So he wore them to school one day, and I was like, all right, I guess he'll just leave them in his locker another day. I picked him up from school one day, and he just came to the car with socks on. And I said, why do you not have your shoes on? He said, well, you told me to leave them in the locker. And I said, but not the day that you wear the shoes. That happened again and again,
Wow. At what point did you go, I should have a talk with this young man?
Yeah. Oh, I talk to him every day.
Okay. Yeah, but you know what? Like father, like son, you said that you didn't have common sense when you was a kid.
I didn't say that.
What I said was, I got out into world and didn't have street savvy.
Oh, street
savvy.
Oh, okay,
and people
savvy.
She just called you ignorant on radio.
No, I did not.
You know, she
said you was ignorant growing up.
You trying to clown me. See, I knew I shouldn't have drove. I knew I shouldn't have driven 30 miles out of my way to come out here.
So your son walked out of school with no shoes on. That means you ignorant too, huh?
Right. Well, like father, the apple don't fall from the tree. You ain't got no sense either. Never again, lady. Never again, tree lady.
Right.
You can go tape up your trees. Tape the branches to the trees. Or whatever it is you do.
Right. I don't tape no branches. Somebody asked me to do
it. Right. I'll be seeing your little Prius riding around the city. In between our talks, I've seen it zipping around the city.
Yeah,
oh my God,
I
there's that tree lady that was
that's
disrupting the concert.
That's right.
Right. And just because I like my check, if y'all want 10% off of your tree work, you can call Donnie the Tree Lady at
770-413-8733. That's 770-413-8733. And actually, my company, Don's Tree Service, is one of our sponsors. So y'all need to check us out.
Yes, because y'all like this show. I like my check. And please sponsor her. You know, it's about to be the winter, hard winter, and the trees down because of the ice. Is there something that they could do to keep their trees up right now?
Actually, if it's dead, dying, or hazardous, it has to go. And I think I talked about that in one of the shows. But with it being the winter, the best thing to do this time of year, believe it or not, is actually a lot of your hardcore pruning. Like when you start getting into, why do I look at you?
There's a tree on the ground outside of Maynard Jackson. It's like out of the roots.
Can
you go by and pick that up?
I can go by and pick it up.
Is that the city's tree?
No, I can go back and pick it up if they pay me to do that. So,
she don't do volunteer work.
Right. Is that something?
I do actually do some volunteer work, but I'm specific about that. So I do some specific volunteer work throughout the city.
Like on your Instagram and your social media, you should put a tree, like emoji, so that people don't get it confused with the other trees. The tree lady. You know how many people have probably Googled her and like turned
and driving her car, and I got a couple of people like, yo, what kind you got? You got that power diesel?
Yeah.
What you got?
You know how many disappointed customers you probably have turned away on Google?
She's
talking about real trees?
Real trees.
Okay.
Oh, get out of here with that.
Right. I don't know trees.
Right.
Oh,
black lady
man.
Doing trees. Yeah, no,
not hey, but that's a good business, though. I'm serious. I'm not talking about the tree business, but, you know,
trees. The game has, like, 18 Lamborghinis off of it.
Yeah, I mean, it's...
I was recently in D.C. for the Christmas holiday.
Is it legal
holiday.
In Georgia yet, though?
Well, I don't care. Oh, but okay. I was in D.C. And it was like, I was trying to order a pizza. They had, you know, the greeneries, okay. too. And it was like a 2-hour wait. No, that's the, I thought about it. It was Christmas. They were closed. But anyway, Donnie, I want to tell you this because it's the new year. I love you.
And I love you too, Marty.
You know, and I appreciate everybody that, you know, puts the show together and everything. Yes. So I just wanted to say that because sometimes we forget to mention, you know, people that are supporting us and helping us out.
Well, while you're doing that, I want to say I love you too. And I appreciate what you bring to the table. And also want to give a shout out to Elijah and a shout out to Jeff, who makes things happen.
And Al, who you never asked to be on the show.
You know what? Al, well, I want you to be on the show one day. Uh-huh. Okay. You are a resident Irish Catholic in the house, right?
I will do that.
Yes, I love it. I love it.
Well, until next week.
I'm just happy to be here.
Okay. Yes, Eric Payne, thank you so much for coming on our show. Yeah. Thank you for being a good sport. We're a little crazy, we know.
You're all right. I just wasn't prepared, that's all.
That's okay. I'm Donnie Jones hanging out with...
Mardy Mardy Ringa.
Yes, and we will see you next week.
Bye.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, this is your girl, Donnie the Tree Lady, owner of Don's Tree Service. Don's Tree Service has been serving the metro Atlanta area for almost 20 years. I'm a certified arborist, and we are fully licensed and insured. Call us at 770-413-TREE. We give free estimates, and we don't charge extra for cleanup. Don's Tree Service, that's 770-413-TREE, or visit us online at donstree.com.
So the reason we went with Don's Tree Service is we needed a couple things done at our house. We needed some trimming of some trees done, but then we also had this old, big, beautiful tree in our backyard that was, our deck was built around this tree, and it was just getting old and limbs were starting to fall, and we just knew eventually it was either going to land on the house or we needed to have it taken down. So we called around and got a few quotes, and then we met with Don's Tree Service, and they were awesome, and we ended up going with them, and I can't say enough about their work. They came in with their crane and got the tree down, and it looks great. I would definitely use them again.